Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Unreal Tips and Tricks series. In this tutorial, we'll learn how to use the enhanced motion blur for fast moving objects by using the new Movie Render Queue Manager in version 4.25. This type of motion blur effect only works when rendering and is not visible from the real-time viewports. Okay, here we are in our scene, and a great example to demonstrate the enhanced motion blur is by having fast moving objects. So I have two sets of speed for my wheel. I've got a slow animation and a fast spinning animation. So let's open the slow one first, and let's play the animation in the viewport. We can see that the viewport manages to capture the motion blur relatively okay. But we do have some slight ghosting going on in this area, as well as some jagged edges near the tire treads here. Okay, so now let's open our fast moving wheel and let's play the animation. So now we can see that we have way more artifacts going on, and this is mostly due to the Temporal AA solution that can't accumulate enough samples to display the motion blur correctly. Now, let's jump into the new Render Queue Manager and go over some settings to explain how to get the best render out of the engine. So let's go into our Windows tab here on the top left and choose Cinematic Movie Render Queue. This will open a new window for you. So currently there are no sequences selected. You have to simply add a level sequence by clicking on the plus render button. And I'm going to go with the fast animation. So once selected, let's go here into our settings. And this will open a default setting window with essentially the output format, the rendering method, and the output folder. So we have the ability to add some features by going to the settings tab, and I'm going to be adding anti-aliasing, console variables, and PNG sequence. So let's open up our anti-aliasing setting, as this will be playing an essential role for the motion blur. The first thing that you want to do here is to override the anti-aliasing to none. So simply check the override setting and make sure it's set to none. With that done, let's check the two settings above, which are spatial samples and temporal samples. I'm going to be setting a value of 2 here, and what the spatial sampling does is render at the same moment in time, but with a slight camera position offset. The temporal sampling works by slicing the camera shutter open into specified subframes, using the engine motion blur to interpolate between the smaller slices. We can see, as per our illustration, that bumping up our temporal samples to 16 will give us better motion blur between the wheel spokes. Okay, we're almost done, but let's just add some extra commands in the console variable. And I'm going to be adding my first line of command by clicking on the plus sign here. And the first item I want to be typing is r.motionBlurQuality. And I'm going to be typing a value of 4 here, and this will ensure to use a cinematic quality blur. Now I want to add a second line, and this is going to be r.motionBlurSeparable, and I'm going to be adding a value of 1 here. And what that does is add a second motion blur pass that smooths out the noise for a higher quality blur. Now, what I can do is actually save this as a preset for my next shots or project so I can quickly load these settings. And I'm going to call this motion_blur_HQ. Great, now with that done, let's go to our output tab and let's define our folder. So I've defined mine here and the output resolution. So I'm going to be using 4K, but you know, use the one you want. And that's basically it. So I'm going to accept here and I'm going to be doing a render remote. And here's the result after rendering. We can clearly see the accumulated rendering method doing a much better job at displaying motion blur compared to the traditional render. I hope you enjoyed this video and hope to see you very soon for new tips and tricks videos.